tonight on WTAJ News at 5.
No, I want something she's going to love, so.
While some people have finished their shopping, others are still picking up last-minute gifts in local shopping centers. A local Christmas dinner tradition was at risk of being canceled this year. We're showing you the man who's stepping up to help his community. And Penn State is in Texas tonight as the football team prepares for the big bowl showdown. I'm David Kaplan. A very Merry Christmas to you and your family. Well, Christmas Day is almost here, and some people in our area still don't feel prepared. Shoppers have been out and about in Altoona picking up last-minute gifts for family and friends. Sean Rapp joins us live with shopping conditions and some last-minute advice if you still need to get any shopping done. Sean, what can you tell us?
That's right, David. Places like the mall and Walmart are closing at 6 p.m., but there are a few other places that will remain open until later tonight. The shopping season has almost come and gone, but no need to worry if you still have items you need. Beth Sanders, a shopper at the Logan Valley Mall, says she has already seen a lot of traffic.
It's been busy, steady. A lot of people are buying online, which is kind of crazy, but a lot of people are coming in. They want to pick that special gift for that special person.
Even though not everyone has something specific in mind, stores have seen plenty of people attempting to find that right gift.
Mostly going to be the last minute shoppers and like, oh no, what am I going to get this person?
Sanders has been done shopping since September, but says if you're still looking, there is always a perfect gift to get somebody.
When all else fails, a gift card to their favorite stores, because after the sales and the new year, they can get a lot more for that bang for their buck.
Target in Altoona is one of the few stores that will be open until 10 p.m. tonight. Other stores will most likely reopen at normal business hours on Thursday morning. Live in Altoona, Sean Rapp, WTAJ News.
Thank you, Sean. And for what you can expect from the weather as you visit loved ones for the holiday, we'll turn things over to meteorologist Veronica Dolan. So, Veronica, it's not really going to look like a white Christmas this year, right?
Unfortunately not, David. If you wanted to see some snow, as we can see, you have to look at Tussey Mountain thanks to our Skynet cam, because it has been mild over the past few days, and we have continued to see mild temperatures for today along with dry conditions. For our temperatures, currently sitting in the 40s. We did reach into the mid-40s earlier today. 40 in Altoona, 42 in Bedford, 41 in Johnstown, also in Indiana, 40 in Punxsutawney, 41 in Du Bois, 36 in St. Mary's, and 39 in State College. Moving into our evening hours, we will, like we saw, see continued dry conditions. So around 6 p.m., seeing our temperatures around the mid-30s, and moving into our overnight hours, we will dip down into the 20s. So what to expect for tonight, our Christmas Eve night, looking to remain dry, seeing a mainly clear sky before we do see just a few patchy clouds at times. Also, just watching out for some fog. So as we move into this evening, besides those patchy areas of fog, as Santa Claus heads out to deliver all the presents for tonight, just looking to be chilly with those lows dipping down into the 20s. So we'll see a low of 26 in Altoona, 24 in Johnstown, 25 in Punxsutawney, 22 in Du Bois, St. Mary's, and Emporium, 23 in Clearfield, 27 in State College, and 29 in Huntington. What to expect moving into later this week? So we will continue to see temperatures well above average for this time of year, our average around the mid-30s, with our temperatures looking to remain in the mid-40s through the rest of this week. We will see clouds building in as we get into the second half of the week, which will bring our next chance for some precipitation to the region. So really going to keep an eye out for that as we head into this weekend. So if you are planning to head back home after the holidays, once we get into Sunday and especially into Monday, we'll begin to see some showers moving into central Pennsylvania and even see some snow back in the mix with our temperatures returning back to average. But I'll have more details coming up in the 7-day forecast with what to expect moving into our Christmas Day and even after, in case you need to plan for those travel plans.
Thank you very much, Veronica. For all you kids wondering when Santa will be putting presents under your tree tonight, we're here to help. On WTAJplus.com, you can find out where jolly old Saint Nick is using GPS. NORAD and its predecessor have been keeping an eye on Santa for over 60 years. No one knows the big guy's exact route, but the tracker could help you know when Santa is in your area and, of course, when kids need to be tucked in for bed. Don't forget to leave those milk and cookies. If you've never visited the state of Texas, you're probably familiar with Jerry World. It's where Penn State plays Memphis in the Cotton Bowl on Saturday, and it's also where we find our sports team this week, including Nittany Nation guru Jack Washer, who's joining us live. Jack?
Hey, David. Yeah, it's Christmas Eve. We're out here at Jerry World, but let's do a little history lesson for you. 45 years ago, when Penn State played in their last Cotton Bowl, they played at the actual Cotton Bowl Stadium in downtown Dallas. Now we're about 20 miles to the west. And if you've never been inside Jerry World, you've only seen it on TV, you know it's big, but until you actually go inside this venue, it's not doing it justice for you. So we actually talked with some Penn State players before they headed down to Dallas and what they thought about playing in such a colossal venue.
We're on the Cotton Bowl, we're playing Cowboy Stadium. I heard that place is sick.
Cotton Bowl is a great bowl, very prestigious, in a great, great place, you know, Jerry's World. Pretty excited to get down there, so just excited to get going.
A hotbed for recruiting, Penn State only has one player on its roster from the state of Texas. But it doesn't mean there aren't still some connections to the Lone Star State.
I fell in love with Texas when I was a kid. My uncle owned a ranch down there. Fell in love with it down there for 2 weeks, and so I think just that experience, being back in that environment, is going to be my favorite thing about going down there.
But for most, it's embracing all that Texas has to offer.
I'm not really a Texas guy, but, you know, I'm going to see what it's like, you know, try to have the best fun I possibly can out there.
Now, the one thing that we have to kind of really know, or what we have to find out, I guess, about Jerry World is a scoreboard. And for punter Blake Gilkin, I feel it's kind of a goal of his to try to hit the scoreboard with a punt. But we'll find out about that later this week. Coming up at 6 o'clock, Peter Terpstra has a story about a Memphis connection on the Penn State roster. For now, I'm live in Arlington, Jack Washer for Nittany Nation.
Thank you so much, Jack. And oh, Jack wearing that polo. Don't you just want some of that Texas sunshine? I'm jealous. Some exciting news for a local bakery. Big Shop Bakes in Tyrone announced they'll be opening a second location soon in Claysburg. They'll offer the same cafe items like the sandwiches and baked goods. The bakery says they're planning to open in early 2020. The new location will be on Dunnings Highway in Claysburg. Christmas dinner in Elk County searching for someone to take over. Well, they found their guy and are getting ready to serve their annual free meal tomorrow. Our Allison Gens tells us more about the preparations.
The tables are set at First United Methodist Church for St. Mary's Christmas Day happening. But 6 months ago, this tradition was almost at risk of not happening at all.
It's an empty room now, but soon, seated at these Christmas-clad tables will be dozens of people ready for a warm meal and the company of others.
Well, it was started 25 years ago by Veda Liptak and Shirley Alexander, who were both members of the Methodist Church, and they just decided that it was needed in the area.
Veda Liptak passed away earlier this year, leaving the Christmas Day happening volunteers in search of a leader.
I had co-chaired for like 10 years. I was ready to co-chair again, but I did not want to be leader. And Ed Schlimm stepped up.
It's a great thing. We wanted to keep it going.
Schlimm says he decided he'd be the one to keep the tradition going.
I had reservations at first, and you know, it's out of the comfort zone. But like I said to people, everyone's been wonderful, so it's helped a lot.
Starting at 12:30 Christmas Day, they'll deliver and serve nearly 300 meals.
We have turkey and ham and all the trimmings.
To those most in need of comfort, company, and Christmas cheer.
Now, the organizers do ask for reservations in advance for this meal. However, they don't turn anyone away. In St. Mary's, I'm Allison Gens, WTAJ News.
Still ahead tonight on WTAJ News at 5, we're continuing to bring you the sounds of the season from across our area. Plus,
well, dry conditions and mild temperatures continue for our Christmas Eve, but what can the region expect for Christmas Day? I'll have more details coming up.
Girl, I'm proud of you.
Can you find me in here?
Have a good day, honey.
Mrs. Boyer today. This is to recognize all that you do.
Every month, join WTAJ in recognizing someone making a difference in their community, making it matter.
Berger and Green are proud sponsors of WTAJ's Making It Matter.
Toyota-thon is... Oh, wait. Toyota-thon is on. Come in today.
Save big on an adventure-ready RAV4 with up to $2,000 total cash allowance.
That's a wrap.
Toyota, let's go places.
At Speedy Furniture and State College, we designed our model to save you money. By reducing our overhead, we can beat sales prices every day without sacrificing big selection and rapid delivery. Visit Dave and Stacy at Speedy Furniture today.
It's the Credit Amnesty event at Team Chevrolet Buick GMC in Huntingdon. If you've got a job and bring home $350 per week, you could be approved with as little as zero down. Push, pull, drive in any trade, or even bring a picture of your trade. Don't even wash it. Plus, we'll take any trade, even if you're upside down. And we'll buy your car for cash, even if you don't buy one from us. Pre-owned 2018 Chevy Cruze. Zero down, $13,990. It's the Credit Amnesty event. You could be approved with as little as zero down at Team Chevrolet Buick GMC on Route 22 in beautiful Huntingdon.
Sometimes the pressures of today's world can make it tough to take care of yourself. But Nature's Bounty has innovative ways to help you maintain balance and help keep you active and well-rested. Because, hey, tomorrow's coming up fast. Nature's Bounty. Because you're better off healthy.
Are you sleeping in plastic bags and a lip mask?
My skin is so dry and cracked, I need serious relief.
That's why I use O'Keefe's night treatment.
Get visible results in one night and guaranteed relief. Available in O'Keefe's Working Hands, Healthy Feet, and Lip Repair.
At Chevy, we're all about bringing families together.
This time of year, that's really important.
That's why our Chevy employee discount is now available to everyone.
The Chevy price you pay is what we pay.
Not a cent more.
Family is important to us.
So happy holidays.
And welcome to the family.
The Chevy family.
Use your Chevy employee discount for everyone to get a total value of over $11,800 on this Silverado All-Star.
See your Central PA Chevy dealers.
What does help for heart failure look like? It looks like this. Entresto is a heart failure pill that helps improve your heart's ability to pump blood to the body. Don't take Entresto if pregnant. It can cause harm or death to an unborn baby. Don't take Entresto with an ACE inhibitor or alisgerin, or if you've had angioedema with an ACE or ARB. The most serious side effects are angioedema, low blood pressure, kidney problems, or high blood potassium. Ask your doctor about Entresto.
The beat goes on.
Yeah.
Toyota-thon is... Oh, wait. Toyota-thon is on. Come in today.
Go off-road in a 2019 4Runner and get $1,250 cash back from Toyota.
That's a wrap.
Toyota, let's go places.
Check out WTAJ's weather app. Real-time radar. Watch your Weather Authority forecast and see what's happening tomorrow and the rest of the week. Download your Weather Authority app. Available now from Google Play and the App Store. Kitchen Saver is a proud sponsor of WTAJ News. WTAJ News continues.
11 states, including Pennsylvania, have taken initiative to create the Transportation and Climate Initiative to find ways to reduce that pollution. The idea came from carbon emissions from gasoline-powered vehicles. But the idea from state environmentalists is getting pushback for raising gasoline prices. The plan would require wholesalers of gasoline and diesel in PA to buy carbon credits to sell their fuel, the cost of which would be passed on to consumers.
We're going to pay one way or another. It's better to pay some money and have it be deployed in a smart way and save overall $10 billion from reduced public health costs.
So far, Pennsylvania is non-committal. The statement from the Department of Environmental Protection says, quote, "We are not yet supportive and will not make any decisions until the program is fully designed."
Now your Weather Authority forecast with meteorologist Veronica Dolan.
Well, the sun is setting on central Pennsylvania, yet another mild and dry day for Christmas Day. And Unfortunately, because of the warm temperatures, not seeing a white Christmas, but if you did want to see a little bit of snow, as we can see, you can take a look at Tussey Mountain thanks to our Skynet cam. Temperatures for today reached into the mid 40s and still hanging around that 40 degree mark. 40 in Altoona, 41 in Johnstown and Somerset, 42 in Bedford, 49 in Huntington, 39 in State College, also in Lock Haven, 40 in Clearfield, 36 in St. Mary's. And moving into our Christmas Eve evening, we'll see continued dry conditions, mainly clear sky, just a few patchy clouds at times, and then also going to watch out for some areas of fog late tonight and into early tomorrow morning. But moving into this evening, we will gradually see our temperatures dipping into the 30s before we do see a low of 24 this evening. Our average for this time of year is the mid 30s, but we are continuing to see mild temperatures across central Pennsylvania moving into our Christmas Day and even into the later part of the week. So in terms of heating, your thermostat getting a little bit of a break, especially during the day, with our temperatures still hanging around the mid to upper 40s, especially for Christmas Day and into Thursday and Friday. We'll see our highs reaching into the upper 40s and lows for the Friday and Saturday nights looking to only dip down into the upper 30s. So as we can see, that is also above average. So thermostat, like I said, just getting a little bit of a break as we move into the rest of this week. But for tonight, like I said, dry conditions, seeing a mostly clear sky, a few patchy clouds at times, watching out for some fog. But in terms of Santa Claus delivering those presents this evening, besides those areas of fog, he won't have any problems, with lows dipping down into the 20s for tonight, and as we saw, clear sky. So for our evening, seeing a low of 26 in Altoona, also in Indiana, 24 in Johnstown, 25 in Punxsutawney, 22 in Du Bois, also in St. Mary's and Emporium, 27 in State College, 28 in Lock Haven. Our setup moving into the second half of the week, high pressure continues to keep things dry. So for our Christmas Day, once again, seeing a mix of sun and clouds along with dry conditions. For our Thursday, we'll begin to see just a little bit more cloud cover building into the region, and that will be the general trend moving into the second half of the week before we do see our next chance for some precipitation by the weekend. But for tomorrow, temperatures remaining mild, reaching into the 40s, 46 in Altoona, 49 in Huntington, 45 in State College, 48 in Lock Haven, 43 in Clearfield. And a look at the rest of our 7-day forecast for our Christmas Day, looking to remain nice, temperatures still in the mid 40s, 48 for our Thursday. Like I said, we'll begin to see a few more clouds building into the region by Friday, seeing a mostly cloudy sky, watching out for some patchy drizzle or light showers in some spots. And by Saturday, looking to remain cloudy, temperatures still on the mild side. And we'll see our next chance for some showers for Sunday. So rain passing through for the end of the weekend, and by Monday, continuing to see that rain moving through. And we'll also see some flurries in the mix. And by the time that system moves out of the area, we'll begin to see some more flurries, and temperatures also cooling down into our Tuesday. So for Monday, looking to see more of that snow moving in Tuesday as well, and then we'll get our temperatures finally back to average.
Okay, and a little bit of fog, like you said, but not too much for Santa, Rudolph, and the reindeers.
Yeah, Santa will be good tonight, and you know, you have Rudolph, so he'll shine his nose tonight real bright, and they'll be all set.
Speaking of shining stars throughout the holidays, WTAJ and Studio 814 are bringing you the sounds of the season into your home. Musicians from across the area have been participating, and now Du Bois Christian School is bringing us the song Christmas Time Is Here.
For all the children call their favorite time.
great harmony. Oh, I love that. Now I want to watch Charlie Brown and the Peanuts, right?
Absolutely, especially for this time of year. You want to watch Charlie Brown, the Christmas tree, and I think Charlie Brown gets a dog for Christmas. Those are always fun.
Yeah, and have a little hot chocolate.
Yeah.
All right, coming up next on WTAJ News at 5, a community rallies to help a veteran with an infectious personality.
Breaking news anytime. Download the WTAJ News app to stay connected with local news, weather, sports, and more. News from your neighborhood. When you are on the go and need to know, WTAJ, your news leader.
Nobody puts Santa in the bargain bin. Nobody. The Ford F-150 has available best-in-class payload, and this sleigh is bringing the big man home. Ford, built for the holidays.
Lease a 2019 F-150 for just $175 a month for 24 months. Visit a neighborhood Ford store dealer near you today.
The holidays are here, and the deals have only just begun at Tyrone Ford. Take advantage of our exclusive holiday sales event, like this 2019 Escape for only $21,999. Or 0% financing for 72 months on 2019 F-150s. Hurry in today. The holiday sales event ends soon. Conveniently located between exit 41 and 45 off I-99 and Tyrone. Only a half mile from Del Grosso's amusement park. Tyrone Ford. It's better in the country.
It always makes my day when I hear from our clients. Listen for yourself.
I had heard good things about Edgar Snyder, so I called up.
Those folks were just the greatest people.
They were just so kind, and they welcomed me with open arms and just reassured me that everything was going to be all right.
They treated me like a friend and not as a client.
And at that point, I realized that this is where I needed to be.
I'm very thankful for the service that I received.
You have wonderful people working for you.
Surprise! A new Buick?
To James, from James.
Hey, is this a new Buick? I secret Santa'd myself.
I shouldn't have. I have been very good this year.
I love it.
Don't forget you this holiday season. Celebrate the holidays with 25% below MSRP for current eligible non-GM owners and lessees on most 2019 Encore models. Or current eligible lessees get this low mileage lease on this 2019 Encore for around $119 per month.
This holiday season, if you're looking to stuff some stockings, may I suggest the Bryce Jordan Center, because we have tickets.
Tickets to great family fun like the WWE Road to WrestleMania Live on February 29th, the Harlem Globetrotters Pushing the Limits on March 2nd, Hot Wheels Monster Trucks Live on April 25th, and of course, Penn State men's and women's basketball.
Be everybody's favorite gift giver this holiday season and get tickets now at bjc.psu.edu.
I love driving my Subaru Ascent through downtown, feeling the holiday spirit.
And Subaru Share the Love event! Woo!
The Subaru Share the Love event is back at Stuckey Subaru. Now until January 2nd, buy or lease a new Subaru, and Subaru will donate $250 to one of four national charities, or locally...
to us, the United Way of Blair County. Every dollar raised helps 29 nonprofits build a better Blair County.
Yeah, like us!
Join the movement
and put a little love in your heart.
Stuckey Subaru. We're here for every mile.
Do you light up the skies like the Griswolds? WTAJ wants to see your holiday lights. Submit your photos on WeAreCentralPA.com's 31 Nights of Lights contest, powered by Brent Cogan Electrical Services, for a chance to see your home featured on WTAJ News at 11.
Five Star Mitsubishi is a proud sponsor of WTAJ News. WTAJ News continues.
A military vet who says he fell victim to a scam is getting some holiday love from people in Fresno, California. Kornhoggard reports he got all his money back and then some, thanks to the generosity of strangers.
Hey, come on in, guys and gals. Oh, you brought a lovely lady with you, hot diggity.
You wouldn't know it from his attitude.
I'm glad you're here. In fact, I'm glad I'm here, too.
But Floyd Smith lost a huge part of his retirement savings to a man who done window work on his house shortly after his wife died. Smith says that man, Mark Glazer, claimed he was in real financial trouble. Floyd loaned him about $10,000 and never got it back. A lot of you saw Floyd's story on ABC 30 and decided to do something. In fact, 374 people actually made donations to him.
We wanted to present this to you.
Oh my goodness. Wow. Honey, look at this. $12,472.60. Look at that.
Floyd served in the Navy as World War II came to a close. He wants to go back to sea, or at least the beach, for a honeymoon with his new wife. He doesn't take it for granted that he gets a second chance.
Isn't that amazing? So many good people in this world.
A hotel in Cayucas also donated a two-night stay for Floyd and his wife. And to be sure he can hear everything from now on, Beltone is donating some brand new hearing aids in January. He acknowledges it's not his ears, but his mouth that can sometimes get him in trouble.
I tell you what, God has his arm around my shoulders.
Yeah, he does.
And his hand over my mouth.
He sure does.
But for this wonderful occasion, he burst out in a little song for the newest love in his life.
If you should run into a 5'2" covered with furs, diamond rings, and all those things.
With his new check in hand and his love by his side, he leaves us with a few words of wisdom.
Smile and the world smiles with you. Cry and you cry alone.
Isn't that great? Still ahead on WTAJ News at 5:30, a fiery crash closes down a portion of the PA Turnpike. We'll show you what emergency crews were faced with. Plus, more people are traveling this year than ever. Find out everything you need to know before you get in a car or on a plane. And as we head to break, here's a look at Bedford.